assisting an empowering organization to solve problems. The SDGs have been developed in order to set new goals, hard to reach goals, and in order to mitigate very major threats on humanity. These are the environmental and societal threats. So we cannot ignore those things by talking about current problems that companies have, banks have. We have to find a way to solve a major problem. The UN has defined a major problem. They believe that globally we need about 9% of the global GDP every year to be invested to mitigate those risks. So that means that we have to move from billions, in many cases only millions, to trillions. This is a jump. It's not a problem. This is a huge leap because it's a thousand times larger. So the question is how to do it. Because if Iran said that to ignore reality is possible. However, you cannot ignore the consequences of ignoring the reality. Okay? So we have to find ways. I think that there are two ways. There is one way to solve two major problems. One is to solve the millennials' problem of their retirement security. The millennials will be the majority of the working population soon in this continent. So it means if they don't have retirement security and also employment security, which is something that has not been discussed in the previous discussions, it's a major problem. I think there is a way to solve it. Okay? The second thing that can be solved, and what I'm going to suggest in a minute, is also where to find the huge amounts, the trillions that can be found. They can be found actually domestically. A person cannot lift himself or herself off the ground by pulling by the bootstraps. However, a country can do that, and easily. There are many examples of countries that have done it. In my country, Israel, has done it over four or five decades, the first decades of its establishment. We were, at that time, very underdeveloped country, and now we are quite a developed country due to what has been done. The trick to solve these two issues was the same problem existed in Israel 70 years ago when Israel was established. The population was very young, and they needed to have some retirement security in the four or five decades later, and the capital markets were thus became out from a terrible war, and we doubled the population in 1 year, tremendous pressures, and so the question was how to solve it. And they came to the idea, we can solve it by ourselves. How? Let's establish retirement funds to the population, pension plans, insurance plans, whatever. However, these plans would not be attractive unless they offer a substantial yield to the investor. So how can we offer substantial yield to the investor? Let's find investments that can do that. However, private investors don't see all the outcomes of the investment because some of them are externalities. Only the public see them and not the private investor. For example, let's say in the current situation, it would like be considered to invest in a solar station, solar power station. So the investor would see the revenue only from selling the power, the energy. However, the country sees other benefits, less pollution, prevention of health issues, etc. So the country can subsidize the difference. Or there must be some way to internalize the externalities, as we say, to endogenize the externalities, as we call it.
Thank you very much.
So this is the solution. And the, in order to do that, it's very simple. The, you have to go through a paradigm shift and through transformation. People are afraid from the term transformation because they, people are afraid of changes, and transformation seems to be even a larger and a bigger threat, a bigger revolution. But this is just coming out. It's actually a simple process. We just have to look at things differently, and suddenly you open up tons of options and opportunities. And this can be done, and we can do that in short time. We can take an organization and teach you how to do it, and then you do it by yourself. It's so easy. We have done it in many places.
Okay, I just need to thank you very much.
What I said, just to finalize, it's really I'm suggesting to start using the internal sources and to use the development banks to by channeling most of the money to the development banks. And as and since most of these institutions are at least partially public ownership, we can use them to serve these SDG goals.
Yeah, we have 10 more minutes. I'm just trying to pull out.